Okay, so we're ready to, everything is clean as can be, and we're ready to apply another coat of Waterlox or several coats. Yesterday I showed you how to use a foam brush to apply Waterlox. Today I want to show you another technique, and it's one of my favorites. You really can't use just a cotton rag and finish, because believe it or not, there's a lot of lint in this, and the lint will break down, the solvents in the finish will break it down, and the Waterlox is so sticky that it'll drag little pieces of lint off and trap them in your finish, so you don't want that. Well, the way you can get around it is you can just trap the piece of cotton inside a pantyhose and then tie it off. And so you have a disposable finishing system right here. The pantyhose acts as a screen to trap the lint inside it. And the nylon has no lint or any particles that come off of it. So I watch for these on sale at drugstores. I like the knee highs. Or I have a 90-year-old next door neighbor, and she also saves me those granny support knee highs are they're the best. They're real thick and heavy duty, and she gets such a kick when I call her up if I need some and ask her if I can have some pantyhose. She just giggles her head off. But these are great, and I'll show you. This is all I do is I just and then you can save this part. The waste part is you can use for like really heavy duty finishing if you need to put a big, like a folded towel in it, if you're really having to put a lot of material on. But we don't have that much, so I'm just gonna put this down here in the foot. And I try not to be wasteful, so I buy these rags at Home Depot. You can buy a box of rags for about $7 or $8, and so they're good, clean rags. And a lot of times I'll rewash some of them. Some of them get so nasty with oil and stuff that I just pitch them. But that's a good cotton, clean rag. So all I do is I just put it in there and then just tie a knot in it just below. And then sometimes if it was, you know, the next one will have two knots in it. So there'll be a knot here and a knot here for the next pad that I make out of this. But this one, you can see this one's already been, I've already completely used that other side of that leg. So I've made a bunch of pads out of that. And then you just cut it. So the next pad, like I said, you tie a knot in it, you put your pad inside it, and you tie another knot in the other side. And so you can get 4 or 5 pads out of one leg. And so here you've got a nice lint-free finishing applicator that gets into all kinds of little cracks and crevices. And you know, because you may live in the country and not have access to foam brushes, or foam brushes may be expensive where you live. They're cheap where I live. I can get them for 59 cents a piece for the big ones. But I know in some places they're very expensive, you know, $1.99 or $2. And, you know, if your wife wears pantyhose and you save them, and everybody can come up with an old part of an old t-shirt or something. So you've got a great applicator that you can apply your finish with and then just toss it when you're done. You don't have to clean it or anything. Let's pour some Waterlox and get started. So you remember yesterday I squeezed my can, so I've got a vacuum in the can, and I don't have to worry about anything popping out. I just carefully remove my cap again. You know, I don't want to damage that cap. I want to use it for the whole life of this. So there's the Waterlox right at the top. I don't want to tip it over or I'm going to spill it. And remember, have the cap up in the can, and you can pour without making any mess whatsoever. And that's probably about all I need tonight, because I'm gonna need less material than I did last night. And again, I always put my cap on this and put it somewhere where I can't kick it over and waste my investment. I don't like to have the stuff on my hands because it is a heavy duty finish, so I like these cheap nitrile gloves, and these are the same ones I wore last night, so I just save them and try to reuse them a couple times. The nice thing about this is that, you know, depending on how big a pad, depending on what you're finishing, if you're finishing a tabletop, you can actually make a really thicker pad out of like an old towel or something. So it's something that's really absorbent and can hold a lot of material to just really get it out there and get your finish on really quickly and be done with it, get on with it. But this one I don't think we need. That's why I just had a little piece of t-shirt inside this. That's all we need. But I like to get it, you know, good and saturated. so it's good and good and uniform. And then here we go. So all we really want to do is get it out there, get it laid out as uniform as possible, and then we'll straighten it out after we get all of it coated. We have plenty of time to do that. We don't have to race it that much. I can see that this is just really laying up on top of the existing finish. Since we put two coats on last night, it's not penetrating in, you know, nearly as much. These applicators are really great for doing wiping stains also. You know, you can do it with a brush, but you have to clean a brush. These are really good. You can use that little knot to get down into corners and stuff also, and edges. That's really jumping out, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Now on a third coat, you can really see that figure jumping out. She's gonna be pretty happy with this door. Okay, I'm gonna flip these guys over, get the other side hit, and then come, and then I can kind of straighten it out. And again, this is open air, so I'm not wearing a respirator. It's very good ventilation out here. But if you do this indoors, especially if you're required to finish in the wintertime with a heater on or something, you gotta wear an organic vapor respirator or you'll damage your health. And you don't need that. No one needs that. That's another reason to do your finishing at the end of the day, so the fumes can dissipate overnight. So when you come back into your shop in the morning, you can air it out and get on with your work. But what's happening is, you know, this is the Tung oil is carried in a mineral spirits vehicle, and that's mineral spirits has to evaporate out for the polymerizing chemical reaction to take place, and so there's just some pretty powerful organic fumes in the air, and it's just bad for your health, bad to breathe it. Man, that looks great. This is just, that's just too much there. That is. The wood's got flaws. It's not perfect, it's a natural thing. I don't like to pour fill and do a lot of crazy stuff like that. I don't mind seeing the grain and some of the defects. I just like to see things very nicely sanded so the wood is polished up and so things are straight and uniform for a finish. Without a lot of blowout and mechanical, I don't like to see a lot of planar ripple and things like that. That just really bugs me. And in a finish like this that's so clear and iridescent, you can't get away with sanding scratches or planar ripple and things like that if you haven't sanded them out, or uneven surfaces, so it will show. See, I can squeeze out my pad here, get most of the material out. Just so now when I just start laying this out and straightening it, just really putting a nice, fine, even, light coat on. So you can use this pretty much like you'd use the foam brush, where you can really use it to just kind of straighten and draw things out after you get the right amount of material on. And you'll only know that by experience and weather conditions and wood.